Do you suffer from sleep apnea and are looking for a battery-powered CPAP solution for hiking, camping, or traveling in general? Then this video might be interesting for you. My name is Christopher. I got my sleep apnea diagnosis 7 years ago, and I've been hiking for a few years. And I will be showing you a really nice solution where you can use your normal mask, which you use at home, and cheap LiPo batteries that are normally used for drones and radio-controlled cars. And you will be able to charge them using a normal USB-C power delivery power adapter. And another great thing about this solution is that you will not need to custom make any cables. You can just buy everything off the shelf. Okay, so here's the full set of equipment that I use for sleeping one night in a tent. First, I have my normal mask, which uses a 22mm connector. And I have a 1.2 meter long hose with a 22 millimeter rubber connector. And I have the travel CPAP itself. This is a Z1 Auto made by a company called Breas. It uses a 15 volt power. This is a 1.8 amp hour 15 volt LiPo battery. And this will last me for 8 hours of sleep. I will show you some other battery options later, which will last you up to 6 nights. This is a small battery monitor, which will monitor the charge of the battery. And this will beep when the charge drops too low, so you need to charge or replace the battery. And all of these batteries that I will show, they use a standard XT60 connector, which is very common. And then I have a short adapter cable that will connect the battery to the CPAP. And lastly, I have a protective bag for the battery, just for safety. So let's assemble everything. First, I plug in the hose in the CPAP. Then I plug in the hose to the mask. Then I plug in the battery monitor for the battery. And the adapter cable to the battery. And I put the battery in the protective bag. And lastly, I plug in the power cable to the CPAP. And the CPAP will power on automatically. And it's ready to use. Okay, so let's disassemble everything and pack it up and see how much it weighs. So disconnect all the cables. Disconnect the hose. And then I put everything in a plastic bag just for extra protection against water. Something like this. And since I'm hiking, I usually use a stuff bag as well, just for extra protection. So I put everything in the stuff bag. And then let's see how much it weighs. So the scale is ready, and the weight is 741 grams, which is 1 pound 10 ounces. Now, you may need some extra equipment like this muffler to reduce the noise or some earplugs, and that will increase the weight of the equipment to 842 grams or 1 pound 13 ounces. Now, when you're using these travel CPAPs, you need to keep in mind that you're making a couple of trade-offs. First and foremost, these small CPAPs, they do not have a humidifier, so you will be a bit drier than usual. But there are products that you can attach to your mask that can retain some of the moisture in your breath. So if that is a big deal for you, then check that out. But I haven't had a need for it personally, because I don't really need a humidifier anyway. And apart from the CPAP, which is kind of expensive, most of the things is pretty cheap. Even the batteries, depending on which size you want. Okay, so why do I recommend this specific model of CPAP? Well, as I said, this is a 15 volt device. And it turns out that 15 volt LiPo batteries are way more common than higher voltages. If you instead take the ResMed Air Mini, which is another common travel CPAP, then that is a 24 volt device. And 24 volt batteries is not as common as 15 volt batteries. But if you already have a ResMed Air Mini and want to have some kind of option, then it is possible to buy a 12 volt adapter that converts between 12 volts and 24 volts. And then you can use 12 volt batteries. But that will bring up the weight a bit, so I won't go into much more than that. Another great thing about the 15-volt device is that it's also possible to run this off an USB-C power delivery adapter. And in order to do that, you will need to get a special cable that has an USB-C connector on one end and a standard bare plug on the other end. And these special cables, they come in different voltages, so you will need to make sure that it is a 15-volt cable. And you will also need to make sure that your specific USB-C power adapter can support 15 volts on the ports that you want to use. Because it's very common for some ports to support 15 volts and some don't. One way to check if a specific port supports 15 volts is to check the symbols on the port. This one, for example, has a laptop symbol and that indicates that it supports up to 20 volts. And this one only supports up to 12 volts. But to be sure, you need to check the specifications, or there may be some numbers on it. So here is another USB-C power adapter for comparison. This is a 160 watt one from Ugreen, and this one has four USB ports. And the top two ones, they support up to 20 volts. So this power adapter will be able to run your CPAP and charge your LiPo batteries, and also charge your other devices at the same time. So it's really nice. Next, I will show you some other battery options. This is the 1.8 amp hour battery I showed you earlier, which lasts me 8 hours of sleep. And this cost me around $30 or euros. And this weighs about 178 grams or 6 ounces. Next, I have a 2.25 amp hour battery. And this lasts me around 10 or 11 hours of sleep, so a little bit more snoozing. And it costs just a little bit more. And this weighs 225 grams, which is almost 8 ounces. Next, I have a 4.5 amp hour battery, and this lasts me around 3 nights. And it costs around $60 or euros. And it weighs 428 grams, which is 15 ounces. And lastly, I have this big 10 amp hour battery, and this one lasts me 6 nights. And last year I went on a week-long hike in Kungsleden, the King's Road in northern Sweden, and this is the only battery I needed to bring, because I had a charging stop planned after 6 days. And this battery cost around $100 or euros, so it's a bit more expensive, but it's still a lot cheaper than the official batteries for the CPAPs. And with these bigger batteries, you will also need a bigger protective bag. And this 10 amp hour battery, it weighs 790 grams, which is 1 pound and almost 12 ounces. And with a protective bag, it's 865 grams, which is 1 pound, 14 ounces. So if you're going on a short trip, you can bring a small battery. But if you're going on a long trip, you can bring the big battery. Or if you go even longer, you can bring a combination of batteries. So, in order to charge these LiPo batteries, you will need to buy a LiPo charger. And there are many options to choose from. One really nice charger I recommend is this SkyRC B6 Neo. And in order to use this, you just plug in the battery. And then you just plug in an USB-C power adapter. And if the power adapter supports 20 volts, then it will charge the battery really quickly. So, to summarize a bit, other than the CPAP mask and hose, if you're going on a really long trip, you will probably need one of the big batteries, this 10 amp hour battery. And if you also need to charge, you can bring the LiPo charger. And that one weighs 83 grams, which is around 3 ounces. And if you want to be able to run the CPAP off the USB-C power adapter, you will need a cable for that. So, if I add together all of the equipment I need due to my sleep apnea, I get a total weight of 1,509 grams, which is 3 pounds and 5 ounces. However, I didn't add the weight of the USB-C power adapter, because this is something I bring along anyway. But if you want to add that as well, then it's 208 grams, which is 7 ounces. And a long USB-C power cable, it's around 50 grams, which is around 2 ounces. Oh, and another last thing. If you're bringing one of these big batteries, you may want to be able to charge your phone or other devices from them. So you won't need to bring any power banks. Then you can bring one of these USB chargers that you plug into the battery. And if you want to be able to run your CPAP as well, then you can buy one of these Y connectors. So you plug it in the battery, and you plug in the charger, and then you plug in the CPAP on the other port. And this way you will be able to charge your other devices as well. So that's it for this video. Please leave a comment or write if you have any questions. You can check the video description for a list of all of the equipment shown in this video. And I will also make a follow-up video soon where I will go into more technical detail of all the equipment and a few recommendations of some USB-C power adapters you can use for charging your LiPo batteries. So see you in next video. Bye bye!